With over 18,000 acres of island-studded water and prime walleye habitat, Dinorwic Lake in northwest Ontario is part of a chain of lakes including Wabagoon Lake and the Wabagoon River, which provide anglers with plenty of opportunity to fish for trophy game fish, including walleye, muskie, smallmouth bass, crappie, and yellow perch. During our trip to Dinorwic Lake, we visited with the hosts of Pine Sunset Lodge, Mitch and Sharon Gusick, who operate this family-friendly Northern Ontario lodge and have excellent knowledge of the lake and where to fish for these prized game fish. Luckily, we arrived on fish fry night and enjoyed a mixed buffet of different species of fish and all the fixings, courtesy of the lodge hosts, and had an opportunity to talk fishing with other guests at the lodge, a great way to start a trip. I was fortunate enough to fish with Sharon, who not only shows her customers where to fish, she is one heck of a good angler and put us right on the right spots at the right times.
We're gonna fish off the edge of a shoal?
My hump, right over the top. And the edge is in the top. They're okay. Not big, but they hold fish.
Gotcha.
That's why people can't find them sometimes, because they're just not big enough. They see you
sitting. Those are the spots I like.
They see you sitting somewhere, and it's like they can never find it. They're going around in circles.
Yep. Good thing for GPS too, right?
Yep.
When you want to come up here, you know, you can hire either a guide, or I'm sure that the lodge can set one up for you and stuff, and it just makes things a little bit easier when you get a good idea of the lake and you're familiar with it then, where to fish, and maybe where there's rocks or shoals or where not to fish, just makes the learning process a lot easier. But overall, you can't beat these little quarter ounce jigs. Like, we were fishing as deep as 22, 23 feet of water in some, you know, windy conditions with some gusts and stuff, and we still kept bottom contact, and that's key here, bottom contact. When you're working down a shoal edge or in front of islands or different points and stuff like that, let out line as you go down. And I'm not saying fish right on the bottom, but make sure you have that bottom contact so you know that whatever it is that you're fishing or you see on the sonar, potentially you can catch. Have the bottom contact, lift up, and when you drop your rod tip, when you see a little bit of slack, you know you're on bottom. Lift up again, because most of these fish here, the crappie, the walleye, sauger, northerns, everything was just off that bottom. So that jig having contact with the bottom and a little higher produced for us. Decent. And little walleyes too, huh? That a slot size fish?
Or
just below the slot?
That is about, maybe so, 16 inch. Yeah.
So 16 inch are eaters, right?
You betcha.
Easy walleye. You eat it good. Look at that. Right through the schnoz, eh? You measure them, Sharon?
If we'd like, yeah.
Because 18 and below are keepable, edible fish, right? And your slot are 18 to... Look at that, right, almost 16.
Yep.
So that's an eaten size fish.
You bet.
They're nice chunking.
Yeah.
Beautiful eaters, look at that. Gorgeous. Say hello, Mr. Walleye. Look at that little vampire teeth right there. Look at that, that's what takes off your minnows, right there. So that's eaten size fish right there. Dinorwic Lake, my first walleye. Yes. We come out to another area of the lake, and you know what these spots are? Her secret spots. So if there's anything on the shoreline that you see you don't recognize, perfect. You know why? Because it's the secret stuff. Now, if you're really good and you book for a week or two or come back, maybe she'll take you out here too. In the meantime, rig back up, maybe catch some more. I love it. Now, for those that are flying in and you have weight restraints and stuff like that, you know, it depends where you're coming from. It's just real simple, you know. Stock some 1/8 ounce if you're going to fish real shallow, if you want to come for the crappie earlier in the year. But for that June to September range, you know, those fish are relating to those bottom contour edges and shoals and drops and ledges and stuff like that. Two sizes and you're set. Quarter ounce, 3/16. Orange with some black and chartreuse, and you're ready to catch fish right here.
Fish on.
You got a good one?
I don't know yet. I'm giving him a second. I'm giving him a second to decide whether he wants to stay on. There we go.
Netter? Nice walleye. Oh yeah, it looks like an eater too. Huh?
There he is.
Look at that.
Nice.
Almost right in. Oh, is that your jig? Oh no, I thought she spit it. Is that about the eating size again?
Oh, I should, for sure. 15 inch.
Beautiful.
We're gonna keep a few for dinner, aren't we?
Oh, yes.
You worked that one like a pro.
Yeah, 15 and a half.
Nice,
yeah.
Here, I'll give you the honors. Beautiful.
Dinorwic Lake is dotted with hundreds of islands, and there are many back bays, rocky points, with weedy plateaus where you'll find an abundance of walleye. The lake is shallower and a little warmer than most lakes in northern Ontario. Thus, in the spring, the water warms up faster, which provides a longer growing season for all species of fish, including baitfish and aquatic insects. As a result, these walleyes have more to eat and a longer season of aggressive feeding before becoming lethargic in the cold winter water. This results in large numbers of walleyes in an easy lake to fish.
Now as for color, real simple. Chartreuse, chartreuse with orange, quarter ounce. Keep it real simple here. You know, I don't think there's a real drastic change of using maybe purple with white or purple with pink and white and that kind of stuff, but it's all about what gives you confidence and focus. And for us, the chartreuse and chartreuse with orange and a little bit of pink did the trick. There you are. Decent little walleye, too.
Awesome.
Probably an eater, huh?
Oh, for sure.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Look at the color of that.
Uh-huh. Sitting right in that weed, isn't he?
Mm-hmm.
I know where you're in that weed. Right through the top yap. Huh? Having our lunch break. Well, it's having lunch break. Look at that. Just a good eating size walleye. Mmm. Tastes good. All right. Going inside. What are we doing now? We're in about 5.5-6 feet of water and some weed. Just vertical jigging. Pulling the weeds up, putting the new minnow on, and between the weed, boop! Can't miss those bites.
No.
Right through the schnoz. Love it. Now as for rods, this was real good because I could just keep it as simple as possible and still have the equipment I need to catch fish here. You know, 7 foot medium light, Legend Elite, and then the St. Croix Legend Extreme, 7 foot medium. So if I want to use maybe heavier jigs and stuff like that, or maybe even a little bit heavier line, go as high as 10 pound or 12 pound mono or fluorocarbon or braid, it didn't really have to do that. I stuck with the 8 pound on both days. But the Legend Xtreme, I fished a little bit deeper. Legend Elite with the medium light, a little shallower. 1-2 punch, both of them put fish in the boat.
Whoa.
Big northern, huge. Dude, look at that.
Hold on, just play him.
Yeah, I just lifted up on him and he was there. He's gonna do a jump. He's a tired one.
Yeah, he is tired.
He has a big head,
skinny.
But a different body, yeah.
Yeah, boy.
From there.
To there.
37,
yeah.
Okay, I'll let him go.
Yeah.
Jeremy, all good?
Yes, yeah. Teeth are missing. Wow.
Yeah. What do you think, Pikey? You got a big head like a big fish, huh?
He's trying to eat, obviously.
Yeah.
But he's not getting anything.
What do you think, Pikey? Ready to go? Huh? There he goes.
Yeah. Huh.
Wow, hey. Northerns. Walleyes, crappie, perch. What's next? Maybe muskie? Wow. In this little channel here. It's just awesome, man. With a little jig going down, I lift up and I go, that's not weed. I looked up and all I just seen with the big head, it's like, look out. Catch and release and having fun.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's keep going. Another one?
Yep.
Any good ones?
No.
We're on them, folks.
Yeah.
Is it?
It's a crappie.
Oh. There's a slab. Look at that. Sharon catches a slab. Look where that jig is. Not too bad, eh, folks? I'd say.
Oh, you barely got it through the meat. Oh boy. Good hook set.
Yeah, cool.
Oh, another crappie for the table. I like it. I like it a lot. Wow, nice slab. Look how nice and wide they are. Thick back. Oh, lordy. Beautiful fish. Good catch. Beautiful, beautiful. Now we're out here 20-something feet of water.
Yeah.
22 feet, vertical jigging. Another one?
No, not yet.
Oh, boy.
Not yet.
I haven't had time to even get a minnow. Sharon setting hook, getting hook, get the net. Wow. Pretty fun, man. Can you believe it? One after another, I'm net man. Seriously, she puts her bait back down again. All of a sudden, another one. I look, big bend. I look down thinking maybe sauger, walleye, whatever. Another slab, even bigger than the last one.
Yep, fish run.
Good one.
Keeping it down just in case it's a crappie. Oh, sure enough.
Oh boy.
There she is.
Yeah. Oh boy. Yeah. Look at that. That's your fish.
Mm-hmm.
That's your fish. What a slab.
Yeah, that's a pig.
Nice one, Sharon. Wow. Oh yeah. Slab, crappie. Beautiful fish.
Closed captioning of this program presented by Sportsman Protein Shake. Black crappie are found in Dinorwic Lake and they're steadily increasing in numbers and getting really big, reaching over 14 inches. If you have never eaten crappie, you should give it a try. They are prized for their sweet meat and the limit on Dinorwic Lake is 15 with a sport license.
Fish.
You got him going?
Yep.
Some weight.
Bone drag. Might be a walleye. Oh,
oh, big slab. Wow, Sharon.
He pulled like a walleye.
That's awesome, man. You are the slab slayer. Slab slayer. Let me open the basket for you.
Some.
It's the ninth inning, folks. What did I tell you about the ninth inning? This could be dangerous. Coming to the plate. Kendrys Morales, home run hitter. Come on, throw that ball.
Oh, there he nice, is. Nice, nice.
How big? What kind? You never know up here.
You never Let's know. That's
oh,
it.
Just a nice crappie.
You never know.
To make our day, huh? Look how yellow that thing is. Mm. Gorgeous, eh? Look at that. Nice sheens, man. Beautiful looking fish, man. I am in heaven, boy. Look at that. That almost concludes our first half of our show from Dinorwic, what's the lake called again?
Dinorwic Lake.
Dinorwic Lake, that's what I thought. I'm delusional from catching so many fish and having so much fun. Look, crappie face. Hey, crappie face. You got a good one?
Fish.
Uh-oh. Oh, no. Another one. Big, big slab. I'll help you.
Okay.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Sharon, that, you did it right there. The first half of our show, phenomenal. Like, that's sick, man. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous?
Mm.
Just get the hook out there. Wow. Sharon, you're a hot stick. Respectfully, too.
No problem.
Look at that. Beautiful crappies, man. Wow. Are you going to come here? Huh? Pine Sunset Lodge, man. Big crappies, Eaton-sized walleyes, big pike, perch. What a fishery. Stick around because we will be right back.
Hi, I'm Sharon Gusick. My husband and I own and operate Pine Sunset Lodge. We've been here for 18 years. We absolutely love the lake. We have multi-species, known for its trophy walleye and muskie, but there's excellent crappie fishing, smallmouth bass, perch, and northern. We have access to lake trout nearby, so if that's an option you'd like, that's available. The lake is gorgeous. It's got all types of water clarity. It's stained water, so bright sun. You don't have to get up early in the morning. You can fish middle of the day. My favorite time on the lake is 10 to 3. Excellent fishing, catch plenty of fish during that time frame. We also have hunting in the fall, so if that's an option, you can contact us about that. And most of our customers bring their own boats. We educate everybody as best as we can with a hazard map, let you know where to stay away or where to fish if you're careful. Then we do have boats as well, so that's if you don't want to bring yours. With the new lodge now, we will be having 10 cabins, and they range in size from a small two-bedroom cabin all the way up to a 16-bed bunkhouse. The cabins are housekeeping only. We don't have a food plan or a meal plan. We do one cookout for the customers one night a week, but you are on your own as far as meals and bring your own food. But cabins are supplied with everything you need to do so. We have a great floating dock system as well, so if you do bring your own boat, there's electricity. We include some bait on your package as well, so that's always a nice feature to have bait on site as well. We open the third week of May every year for walleye opener, although if you do want to come earlier, you could fish for crappie or northern or lake trout. And then we stay open right through September and even early October for fishermen, and then we do our fall hunts.
Oh boy, looks like it's got some.
They always do when they first pull, but yeah, there is some weight on him.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, that's a nice one. That's a slabber. That's what I'm talking about.
Wow, Sharon.
Yeah.
Killer. You are the crappie queen. But look at that. I'm going to show that in the mouth. Yeah. That's where they usually come off, right?
Yeah.
Look at that. Wow. I said, shame, shame, shame. If you can't dance too. Awesome. Love it. Sharon, I'm very impressed. Mm. Your angling abilities, nice lodge, good food.
Thanks.
Boy, in another life, I'd probably be one of your guides. Crappie queen. You know what crappie queen looks like? At the back of the boat, one who's controlling the boat. She has caught some slabs that seriously made me both jealous and feel fantastic. You know why? Because anytime big crappies like that come into the boat, we respect the fishery too. We let some of the bigger ones go, kept one steed, but seriously, Sharon had that, just that touch, I call it. It's God-given, really, because to try to teach it, it can be tough. But when you can just feel that crappie bite, you can feel the walleye bite. She knew sometimes even when saugers were biting. What are you? Oh, you got some size, definitely, whatever it is. And it's shaking its head a bit. It might be a decent
nice
walleye.
That'd
yeah.
Be great.
Oh, it's pretty good.
That'd be good.
Might be, it's not fighting like a pike.
Oh, nice.
Oh, white.
Nice walleye.
Huh? Whoa,
nice
look at that.
Walleye.
Spit it.
Wow.
He just spit it.
Yes.
That's an eater size? Or picture size?
He might be over. He might be a slot.
So it's like in the slot, right?
Yeah.
So that's when you let it go right away?
Well, we should.
Yeah.
If you want
okay.
to get pictures.
Yeah, yeah. For sure. We can do that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, or we can measure it.
Okay, we can do that.
We can measure it.
I'll bet you it is. So 18, right?
Yeah, well, my guess, just looking at him, yeah, he's probably 18 and a half. Oh, just right there.
So
just,
it's almost legal, isn't it?
It is legal, actually.
It is legal, right?
Yeah, it is legal.
So what do you think?
Well, for pictures, I want to release them eventually, but for pictures, we can keep in here.
Okay.
Yeah.
We'll do that.
Yeah.
Perfect. Thank you. Legal. If it was really close to 18, I'm not taking a chance. Because you know what? It's great that M&R and the OPP come out and check boats and stuff. And you know, you have to protect the resorts and stuff. And on this lake, stuff like that, you want to have a future fishery. So those ones, they just,
they know those are probably the best spawners, that 18 to 23. So we let them go, but this one is just a hair about that much, quarter inch or so, so there's no ifs or buts. So we're gonna keep them for a while, take some pictures, then let them go, because those 14, 16s, those are the ones we're gonna eat. Well, I can't say enough of the couple days that we spent up here at Pine Sunset Lodge. Dinorwic Lake, I'd never fished it before in my life. Another bucket list lake off the list, but man, was it fun. Sharon and I shared some laughs, catching some fish, hook sets, fish fries, you name it. You want the time of your life, seriously? Catching all those different kinds of species that you saw that we caught? Give them a call, get on the email, internet, they're on Facebook, they're everywhere. Pick up that phone, call them, and book your fantastic vacation like you saw this guy had right here.
Get hooked on the awesome fishery of Dinorwic Lake at Pine Sunset Lodge and have a taste of Northern Ontario for yourself. Contact the friendly hosts, Mitch and Sharon Gusick, and book your next fishing adventure at Pine Sunset Lodge in Northwest Ontario. The Extreme Walleye Angler has been presented by Go Fish in Ontario. It's catching. St. Croix Rods. Best rods on earth. Sportsman Protein Shake. Power your obsession. Catch us at fishxtreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.